the only way that I knew possible was to record it myself, go and do the drums in the studio, mix it with someone, and then be like, that's the album. Now I've sort of sat down and go, what makes a song work, and what gear do I need to make this step up to production level, and how do I make my voice sound different, or how do I make the guitar sound cleaner? It just felt obscure in what was happening, and I think animation has almost become a bit more adult, and if you can do it in that way, it just felt like hilarious. I love Supergrass, man. That's a huge influence, especially the Cooler Shaker as well. I really like that English Britpop 90s kind of stuff.
Hey.
How you doing?
How are you?
Yeah, good, man. Yeah, just trying to take it a bit chill, like, since the album's sort of been out. And we were in lockdown recently, which was, we had 2 weeks, so just got out this Sunday, which has been nice. So back at the pub now.
And you're based in Perth, right?
Yeah.
How do you tend to go along with this whole strange situation?
I had a big bit of a break over, I think it was November till basically a couple of weeks ago, where I literally have just not recorded anything. I've been trying to pick up the guitar and just sort of doodle around and write bits and pieces, but I want to get into something new. So yeah, just trying to give myself a bit of time and a bit of space from writing, so that when I do come eventually, it's like, all right, I'm really excited to get this album down and start recording. Hopefully get something different than Shyga and move forward in a different way.
Because you've got more time than you used to have, do you become a different songwriter? Do you become a different musician because of that extra time that you get?
Probably. I think probably. With myself, it's like maybe I would try and get out a song or an idea in the only way that I knew possible was to record it myself, go and do the drums in the studio, mix it with someone, and then be like, that's the album. And I think because of that, the production has always been really lo-fi and maybe a little bit crispier than it needed to be in time. Now I've sort of sat down and go, what makes a song work, and what gear do I need to make this step up the production level, and how do I make my voice sound different, or how do I make the guitar sound cleaner and heavier? So I really like that. I think that's where I really got into metal music. It's perfect. There isn't a mistake in metal music, if that makes sense. It's you don't hear, no one makes mistakes in metal, it's sacred. But then when I do it, and put my vocals on it, it sounds awful. So there's a way that I think people have worked out. It's screamo and metal has got this sound and this edge. But I'm still trying to work away about how I can sort of get that.
We need to talk about the clay animations, the claymations.
I love it. Ollie Jones, what a wizard.
Yeah, you start laughing right away. So how did you meet the guy? How did you meet him?
We met Ollie through the doing the last record, whatchamacallit. I think Murray put out something he knew of Ollie through someone else's music video or something that he'd worked on. And he was I have all these styles that I like animating in. And we were just going through all his work and what he had made previously. It just felt obscure in what was happening. And I think animation has almost become a bit more adult. And if you can do it in that way, it just felt hilarious. So I want to do the next album with Ollie, but go for the blob, the little gelatinous orange blob, and have his story about where he came from. But if we go through the albums, we can eventually make this sort of, it might be like a thematic thing about introducing characters, and you've got the style. But then you don't want to kind of do the same thing again. But I like the idea of it.
When I listened to your album for the first time, I ran to my colleague and I said, "Hey man, fuck, it sounds like Supergrass."
I love Supergrass, man. That's a huge influence, especially with Cooler Shaker as well. I really like that English Britpop 90s kind of stuff. Yeah, dude, that's a compliment.
I had the opportunity of working with the people of Supergrass one day in 2000. It was a blast working with them because they are so energetic. So Supergrass, Cooler Shaker, any other 90s British stuff?
Stone Roses, I suppose. Oasis is probably a big one, but I don't know. I'm more of a Blur fan, so I think that used to be obviously a lot when I was younger, but I think it was as soon as I sort of listened to Tame and Dunyan, when it all kind of changed, and then that got me into OCs, which got me into Unknown Mall Orchestra, which got me into like Pond and King Giz, so... It was like, it felt like there was that modern resurgence kind of kicked all that back in my sort of love of listening to Supergrass and Cooler Shaker. And not, I think when I was younger, I didn't understand why I liked it, but then it kind of became prevalent why I did like it when all this stuff was coming out and it sounded like, oh, that sounds like this, but like heavier or more expanded upon. And I think, yeah, as soon as I felt like I could do that, if that makes sense, it wasn't like, I was just not I could do it, but I could sort of emulate in the best abilities of being like, let's try and do this kind of style of music because we can play guitar, we've got a drum kit, we've got this. We could try and put our tiny spin on it, I suppose. And even to be classed with those kind of bands is really humbling. It's always been a bedroom project or just a hobby of mine. So when it kind of comes to a band, we do write well together. It's just, I think it takes so long to evolve a track that if I just at home on a say just a random Monday afternoon, I'm just like, got this riff. I can just record it here. And rather than being like, is everyone free? Is everyone available? It's like, yeah. Just...
Band can be a burden in that way.
Yeah. They're good though.
Yeah, Jack, thanks for being on the line.
Thank you so much for having me, yeah.
And let's try to team up somewhere in 21 or 22.
Yeah, definitely. I would love to be on the show. Yeah, absolute pleasure talking to you. So, cheers, man. Have a good night.
Cheers. Same here. Bye.
Yeah, bye.